Well, hey guys, this is Josie. Welcome back to Cedar Creek Homestead. I'm out here on Thursday, and we've had two nights of freezing temperatures. And I think if I move out of your way, you can see that I've used buckets and coffee cans and all kinds of things to try to protect our tender tomatoes that we've got underneath there. And it's time for me to get them uncovered. We're not going to have freezing temperatures anymore for the foreseeable future. And the temperatures are going to warm up next week. And so I need to get these uncovered. We've got rain coming in tomorrow and maybe even a chance of severe storms. So I got to get busy doing this. And after I get done with this, I'll walk around and show you some other things that may have been damaged. Hopefully not. I know my grapevine's damaged, and I'll show you that. I don't think the pear tree got damaged, and I haven't checked on the peach tree yet. I've got flowers and Howie's marigolds and all the things that need to be uncovered that I protected for this season. So I got to get busy and get this all done, and I'll be back with you in just a little bit. Well, guys, you can see that these tomatoes look pretty good. They don't have much damage. Now, some of them need to have their lower leaves taken off because they're going to be touching the dirt, and that's something that we try to keep control of every year anyways. But for the most part, they're looking fairly good, and I don't see much damage, I don't see any damage at all really on some of these. Now, some of my plants that were down further in some different kind of containers, there's a couple of them that do have some leaves, leaf tips that are yellow, and I'm probably going to take those off. But for the most part, I think my little tomatoes have survived. And so I'm going to show you, I just have cabbages and onions in here so far besides the tomatoes. So I'll show you them. I didn't cover either one of them, and I'll show you what they look like, and then we'll move on to some other things. You can see my little cabbages down through there. And they fared pretty good. They're looking all right. And I don't appear to have lost anything with them. And we'll be looking forward to some fried cabbage and some boiled cabbage and sauerkraut. And we'll see what all kind of mess we can get into. I've got 3, 6, 9, 12. I have 17 cabbages. So we'll see how good they do. I love fresh cabbage, and it doesn't appear that the frost has bothered them at all. And so they do have some of them have some little leaves on them that are looking kind of brown, their outer leaves, but that's not anything new. That's something that we can take care of real easily, and we'll move on to the next thing. Well, here's part of our onion patch, guys, and it goes on down through there, and pardon this fence that's leaning over. The wind got to it, and I'll have to do some repair work on that. But you can see that the onions are doing good. They don't appear to have any kind of damage on them either, and so we're thankful. I will enjoy these onions, and the rest of the family will enjoy them, and we eat onions. I wouldn't say every meal. At supper time do we eat onions, but a majority of the time, especially in the summertime, and cucumbers and onions and just all kinds of things. Sliced onions with beans or black-eyed peas, and you know all that good stuff that you do with onions. And just about every, seems like most recipes that I make for supper meals has got onions in it. But all right, guys, we'll go on to the fruit trees and see what kind of damage we've got there, if any. On the way over here to uncover one of Howie's pots of marigolds, I wanted to show you. This is Howie's little beagles, his rabbit dogs, he called them, and their pen is over by the garden, and they're right across the dirt road. They go this far, and they lay down and rest. And there's been a time or two that I thought they were laying there dead. It scared me to death. But they're alive and well. They just, they know if they come close that I will get them put in their pen. And they are escape artists for sure. Sadie just ran in front of them. But, you know, the They're Howie's dogs, and they're just going to live their little lives. But they're ornery little boogers. They love rabbits, and they won't come to me. So I'll just let them go for now.
Well, guys, here I am at this pot of marigolds. This is the one that I planted and told you the blessing of Howie ordering the seeds for me. The love letter to Howie, remember? The marigolds, and how he sent me a love letter by getting the seeds for me that he didn't like but wanted me to have them. So let's take a look at this one. Now I stuck a fence, electric fence post in there and used a garbage bag, and we'll see how these fared. They didn't fare too bad. There are some that are kind of broken on the top, but for the most part they're looking pretty good, and I will zoom you in there and kind of show them to you. There, like I said, there's some broken tops. I hope you can see this, but I'll get you down here and let you look, and I'm pleased with this one. I'm happy that they're not. I'm happy with this one. They're bent over just a little bit. Some of them had some broken tops, but for the most part, there's not any burnt leaves. Sorry about that. Sadie scared me to death. She jumped over here on me. But anyway, for the most part, they're looking good, and I'm happy about that. It makes me smile to see that these are in good shape.
I'll get you zoomed in there, or at least get you a little bit closer that you can see that they're looking good. I'm so happy about that. That makes my heart sing. So let's move on to the next thing. Well, guys, as you can see, one of the casualties that I had of the freezing temperatures is this grapevine. And it was loaded. Let me get them around here and show you here. Hopefully you can see it. Some of this. The little clusters. Now I think that all might not be lost with this. It could be that I'll have some come out back out. I don't know that for sure, but we'll get this cleaned up the best way we can and see if we can salvage anything. I just don't know. It was looking so pretty, but this is just one of our casualties, and we'll see if we've got some others. Let's move on to our fruit trees and see what we've got there. Now this is the pear tree. I hope y'all can hear the wind has started picked up, and you can see that this little pear tree has got a lot of pears on it. It actually looks pretty good. Now I can't promise that these pears will hold on and stay on there, but they're looking pretty good. I just don't know. Fortunately, some of our fruit trees are babies, young, so they didn't have any fruit on them yet, so they didn't get any damage. But we've got this pear, and I've got a big peach tree that was just loaded. We'll go see it, see if there's any damage to it, and we'll get in the garden. Well, this is my peach tree, and you can see I have a branch broken. That's from the wind. That's not from the frost, of course. So I do have that, some damage there, and I have a few more branches that are going to have to be taken out. But the fruit itself, let me try to get you where you can see. There is a lot of fruit on this tree, but it appears to be okay for now. I don't see any damaged leaves, and the little fruit is hanging on. Now it might in the next few days fall off, but for right now it's looking pretty good. So the pear tree and the peach tree that have fruit on them, and I have some more trees up front, they're looking good. But then I have a bunch of young trees that don't have their fruit on them yet. So I don't can't really well they don't of course have any damage. And so this particular peach tree is looking pretty good, except for that, of course, that damage has got to be cut off for wind damage. And then we'll go over here and look at the strawberries. Here's the strawberries, and I got the tarps off of them, and they're all looking pretty good. I don't see any damage. They're full of blooms. They just, they're looking really good. And of course it goes on down this way, and I do have some bare spots that I need to put some of the runners in and get them planted, but it looks like I'm gonna have a really good strawberry harvest this year. Praise the Lord, the strawberries didn't get bit. And I'll actually be picking these strawberries sometime next month or the last of May, beginning of June, and we'll get to have some yummy stuff with them. I'll actually give you guys a recipe for how my family back in Arkansas, some of us anyways, eats strawberry shortcake. And that'll be fun, and we'll do that when I've got fresh strawberries to share with you guys. So I'm gonna move on. I got a couple more things, garden flower-wise anyways, that need to be tended to and get uncovered. The elderberries didn't have any fruit on them, so I didn't cover them. They're looking good. I'll turn the camera around so you can see them. These are the two elderberry bushes that we planted last year, and they just really took off and grew well. I actually had a couple of heads last year that had berries on them. But I gotta ask you guys that have grown elderberries about this, and maybe you will give me your opinion on it, and I'll try to get in there close to ask my question in just a minute. Hey guys, I hope you can see me back here in this elderberry. And see these right here? Both elderberry bushes have them. And the best I can tell, that's coming up from the roots. My concern is they're really tender and they're not hardwood. Maybe it's just this year's wood. It does look like they have the little spots on them, like what the other ones have. But you'll notice that the leaves are so much bigger than what these are. I hope you can see that. These are so much bigger than what these happen to be. And I don't know if I've got something funny going on or this is really elderberry. If you don't mind putting it down below, tell me, Stace, Josie, whatever you want to call me. Well guys, my snowball bush, it didn't fare as well. It's got a little bit of damage from where this stuff was on them, and they broke over. And so I've got quite a little bit of damage. I got a whole big pocket full of snowball stuff here. And I'm not one to quit. I try to see if I can't grow some new snowballs. I may not be able to, but I'm going to give it a shot anyways. And I have a 9-bark that is kind of smushed, but it doesn't appear to have any frozen parts to it. So I think it'll snap back and be okay. So anyway, there's a report of all of the frozen plants and damage that we've had this year. Not been as bad as what I thought it was gonna be. The grapes got the worst of it. That's kind of disappointing to me because, that was one of Howie's pet projects. But I kind of think that maybe I get some of that old off of there, not old, but damaged, that from the articles that I've read, that sometimes they do come back. You won't get as much fruit, but you still could get some kind of harvest for the year. And if not, hopefully it'll green out and it'll still be pretty.
Well, guys, this is Josie with Cedar Creek Homestead. I hope you guys fared good through this freezing little cold snap that we had. And until next time, I love you, and we're gone.